Welcome back to another very exciting tutorial here at the PhotoshopTrainingChannel.com. My name is Jesus Ramirez, and you can find me on Instagram at JRFromPTC. In this video, I'm going to show you how to adjust facial features in Photoshop. We'll start out with the Puppet Warp Tool, which will allow us to make targeted adjustments. Then, I'll show you the different tools that are available in the Liquify filter that will allow you to make changes to any facial feature that you like. Also, I want to point out that this image really does not need any adjustments. Her face looks great the way it is, so all the adjustments it will make in this video are not only unnecessary, but they're also exaggerated. That is because it makes it easy for you to see how the tools work with extreme adjustments. Keep in mind that when working on any image, you never really want to make an extreme adjustment. Always keep your changes subtle. That way, your results look more realistic and you keep the essence of the person. Okay, let's get started. So I have this image here on this background layer. And what I'm gonna do is we're gonna start adjusting her facial features. So one of the things that you can do to adjust the facial features is to select the lasso tool by pressing the L key on the keyboard and just selecting a part of the face. So why don't we select the mouth? So I'm gonna click and drag and make a selection around the mouth. You always wanna make a selection larger than the area that you need so you can have some room to mask away the edges. So now that I have the mouth selected, I'm gonna press Control J, Command J on the Mac to duplicate that selection onto a new layer. And there it is. Then I can go into Edit, Puppet Warp, and you'll see this mesh around the new layer. You can disable it if you like. For now, I'm gonna leave it on. And I'm just gonna make a few points here on the mouth. I'm gonna disable the mesh. Now, if you only make 2 points, it's not gonna work very well because when you click and drag 1 point, all the mesh is gonna move. The only other attachment is on this point. So that's not something that you wanna do. So I'm just gonna go ahead and cancel that for now. I'm gonna go into Edit, Puppet Warp. I'm gonna re-enable the mesh. And what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna create some points here on the edge that are sort of gonna hold the mouth in place. Then I can add points that will control the mouth. So I'm gonna click here, 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 and here. So now I can click and drag these points and make adjustments to the mouth if I need to. So maybe we can give her a smile, or we could give her a frown, or we can make other kinds of adjustments that we need. Now, as I mentioned earlier, she does not need any adjustments. We're just using this image as an example, but in other images, you may need to use this technique to fix a couple of problem areas. So once you're done making the adjustment to your image, you can just press enter or click on this check mark here. Photoshop is gonna make those adjustments. So there it is, before and after. And you usually wanna add a layer mask and paint with black on edges if you have any. So in this particular case, I don't have any edges around the layer that I created, so I can go ahead and leave it like so. But usually any of these hard edges may cause problems, so you always want to smooth them out with a layer mask. So that's before and that's after. Obviously in this case, we only did a subtle change. I'm going to make a more extreme change now so you can see how this technique could work. And what we're gonna do now is I'm gonna press L on the keyboard to select the lasso tool, and I'm gonna make a selection around her eyebrow. So it's gonna be a pretty large selection. I'm actually gonna include her eye as well, just because, as I said earlier, we wanna select more than what we're gonna use so we can have some pixels to mask and make a smoother transition. I'm gonna press Control J, Command J on the Mac, and now we're gonna distort the eye. You can actually create a smart object out of this layer. So I'm gonna click on Convert to Smart Object to work non-destructively on this layer that we created. So I can go into Edit, Puppet Warp, enable my mesh, create those points that are gonna hold my mesh in place, and then create the points that are gonna distort the eyebrow. So I'm gonna click here, here, and I'm gonna use these points to distort the eyebrow as best as I can. And I think this is gonna work. I'm gonna apply the change by clicking on this check mark, and there it is. I'm not worried about the eye because we're gonna mask that out. So I'm gonna create a layer mask, and I'm just gonna mask out that eye by painting with black. Okay, there it is. If I need to make any changes to my puppet warp, I can double click on puppet warp here and continue making changes to the eyebrow if I need to. Now, I think I have too many points here, so I can actually delete some. So I'm going to click on delete pin. And it removes some of these pins, and I don't think we need this many, so I'm going to remove this one as well. So it looks like we only needed the two on the side, and maybe we don't even need those. So let me just delete them and see what happens. Yeah, I think it's okay if we delete it. And let me delete this one and see what happens with this one. Yeah, that's okay. So we don't need any of those. So we just need the ones here on the eyebrow. And that's the beauty about working non-destructively with smart objects. You can always come back and make adjustments. So actually what I'll do is I'm going to make one other change. I'm going to click on this check mark here to accept the changes. And I'm just going to fill with black on this layer mask. Alt backspace, option backspace to fill with the foreground color. Then I can paint with white just on the areas that I want to reveal. I want to reveal the eyebrow. So the eyebrow's up here. Let me start painting that again. There we go. Now I can see a little bit of the eyebrow, of the original eyebrow there. So let's get rid of that. So I'm going to click on the background layer, the original layer, Control J, Command J on the Mac to duplicate. And on this duplicate object, I'm just going to make a selection around the eyebrow there. And I'm going to click on the patch tool, which is nested under the spot healing brush tool. Click and drag that up right about there. And Photoshop gets rid of the eyebrow. Control D, Command D to deselect. So now she doesn't have an eyebrow. And I can enable that eyebrow layer. So there you go. The eyebrow is back on the right spot. I know she looks a little weird, but that's sort of the point of this tutorial. We're taking things into the extreme. Again, she doesn't really need any of these adjustments. So that's another thing that you can do to adjust a facial feature. So I'm going to delete those two layers and we're back with the original layer. And what I'm going to do now is I'm going to show you how to work with the Liquify tool to make adjustments to facial features. Now, I do have a tutorial that goes deep into the face tool that allows you to make changes to facial features that Photoshop detects, as you can see there. So I'm not going to spend too much time talking about this feature. It's only available in Photoshop CC 2015.5 and newer. So if you don't see this face tool option, then you're probably on an older version of Photoshop. Again, I did a tutorial just on this feature alone. Look at the description for the link to that tutorial. And by the way, that tutorial also shows you how to apply this effect to video. Anyway, so what I wanted to show you here is the adjustments that you can make using the other tools. So I'm going to click on the forward warp tool, which is this one here, and it allows you to move pixels around. Now, what you want to do is always have a large brush. If you have a small brush, when you make an adjustment, it's going to take you a while to make the right adjustments, and you're never going to get it right. So make sure that you're using a large brush. And by the way, to undo, I'm pressing Control-Alt-Z, Command-Option-Z on the Mac. So make sure that you're using a large brush. You can click on the brush tool options here and increase the size, or just use the bracket keys on the keyboard to make adjustments to the brush. Once you have a large brush, you can just click and drag and just make those adjustments as you need to. Another tool that you need to be aware of is the freeze mask tool, which is this one here. Wherever you paint, those pixels will not be affected by the brush tool here. So I painted over the eyes and the eyebrows, and I can come with the forward warp tool and move the nose around. I can move the hair around, but the eyes stay still. So I'm going to disable that mask by clicking on mask options and let me scroll down, show mask. So this looks a little bit weird here on this side because the mask was covering those pixels, but you can see how the mask protected the eyes. So I'm going to go ahead and undo that. Another tool that you need to be aware of to make changes to facial features is the pucker tool. So I'm going to, again, create a large brush and just tap. And notice what happens. It puckers the nose. I'm going to do an extreme there so you can see. Now she's got a really tiny nose. Another tool that you can use is the bloat tool, which is right below that. And the bloat tool does the opposite. Again, you need a large brush for that. I'm going to undo those changes so we go back to where we started. Another tool that I like using to make facial feature adjustments is the Twirl Clockwise tool, which is this one here. And this one can help us give her a little bit more of a smile. So I'm gonna click here to rotate clockwise. And I can hold Alt Option at a Mac to rotate counterclockwise. And I can come in here and make further adjustments with the forward warp tool. So I can come in here and make more adjustments. Obviously, this is not looking very good. I didn't take my time. But again, you can see how you can start making those adjustments. Now, all these things I've been showing you with the Liquify tool are very extreme adjustments. You usually don't want to make anything that extreme. And again, her face is pretty much perfect. There's no changes that we really need to make. But if for whatever reason I decided to make a change, I wouldn't make any extreme change. It would just be little subtle things, maybe nothing more than just a tiny little bit to sort of emphasize the facial feature, like the mouth there, maybe just the eyes, just a tiny little bit, not very much. And then that would be the changes that you make. Also, I wasn't working non-destructively, so you always want to create that smart object. So we have the smart object, we have the Liquify tool. You can come in here and just make really subtle adjustments, press OK. And if we need to come back and adjust them because the adjustments are too strong, we can do that by double-clicking on the Liquify label there and coming in and making any other adjustments. The last thing that I'm going to show you with the Liquify filter is that you have something similar to a fade command. So I'm just going to make an extreme adjustment here. Then I'm going to go into the Reconstruct options here, and I can click on Reconstruct and just click and drag the slider over to the left to reconstruct that adjustment. So if you make something too extreme and just want to scale it back just a little bit, you can use this tool to do so. And that's it for this tutorial. I hope that you enjoyed it and that you learned something new. Make sure that you leave all your comments or questions down below. If you create an image using this tutorial or any other of my tutorials, feel free to share it on Instagram with the hashtag PTCVids. I often do a search for this hashtag to see what you're all up to. If I find your image, I will leave you a comment. Also, don't forget to subscribe and click on that like button. If you have a friend who you think will enjoy this tutorial, please share this link with them now. Thank you for watching, and I'll talk to you again soon.